Good morning. It is 5:09 and I'm just doing some paperwork down in the office. I'm going to get ready to leave in just a few minutes. Today we're starting a new project. It's a pretty good sized driveway, pretty big driveway, and it's actually not too far from where my house is, which is kind of nice. It's always nice when you don't have to travel far for a job. So today we're just going to be doing the excavating and the setup work. It has a lot of excavating to do because the upper portion of the driveway is actually leaning in towards the garage, sending water in the wrong direction. So we need to dig that way down so we can get the water flowing in the right direction off towards the yard. I have actually a few shout outs this morning. First of all, Juan Marshall, he actually makes me, he usually just texts them to me, but he makes these cartoons for me of the guys and just stuff that we have going on at the job. Every time I get one of those, it makes my day, makes me laugh. I appreciate that, Juan. Keep it up. Then Kevin from Michigan, thank you for the mouse pad. I'm actually using it now. He just noticed I needed a mouse pad, so he sent one out. Thank you, Kevin. That's very thoughtful of you. Then Anthony from North Dakota sent me $20 to get donuts and coffee for the guys. I'm gonna wait till later in the week, Anthony, because I want to have Daryl Jr. and Daryl with us so everybody can share in that. I do remember you. I remember the phone conversation we had last week. Thank you very much. And then a special shout out to Grace from Pennsylvania. You wrote me a very special letter and a card, and you gave me a gift. What you said in that letter was very touching. It meant a lot to me. Things like that keep me encouraged and keep me motivated. So thank you very much. All right, so I got to finish up a couple estimates and then I will see you guys at the coffee shop. How much garbage do we make? Morning.
Good morning.
You look so tired.
Yeah.
Come
It was a rough day
on.
yesterday.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Mondays are no good.
Yeah, Fort Collins.
Really?
Yeah.
I had two Collins, so I guess I'm lucky.
Yes.
You guys always keep it rolling. You guys are hiring?
Yeah, 14 an hour.
I could be Scott's assistant. Yeah.
I could work.
Yep.
We'll always have coffee.
That's true. All right, see you later. Morning, Scott.
Good morning.
How's the coffee business?
It's fine. How's it with the video man?
Oh, it's going good.
All right.
You're all set. Have a good day.
Thank you.
See you soon.
Yep.
Bye-bye.
All right, I'm just pulling into the yard. It is 6:07. Thankfully, Mr. Bobby's here because Daryl's not here again. Looks like Bugs is here, and that's it for now. We got a lot of excavation to do today. I wish I had my other driver, but what are you gonna do? All right, so I'm looking for some lock nuts so I can fix the skid loader. The throttle cable came unattached, the nut fell off. So hopefully it's one of these. Hopefully, we'll find out in a second. Have it. It's a miracle.
Morning.
Morning.
Hey Ryan.
Yeah.
Do you have any extra sets of gloves around here?
Yeah, but not right now, dude. Do you have the pressure washer? No, I didn't. I had to fix the skid steer with priority.
And I got my rubber boots. I'll wash everything off. I'll wash off. I'll make sure everything, double check, make sure everything's picked up.
They don't care about the business. We're on a super steep hill here. And I'm not even gonna park the trailer on this hill. Even with chalking the wheels, this hill is too steep, and if that trailer goes, it's gonna be a disaster. And I don't need a disaster, so I'm gonna go park at the end of the block where it flattens out. I'll just drive the skid steer up the hill. It's a nice morning. It's about 45 degrees right now. Sun's just coming up. nice and crisp, but it's supposed to warm up really nice today. It's supposed to be like 74 degrees, which is just beautiful. Just pulled up on a job, just took the skid loader down. Bob's here, Eric and Francisco are just pulling up. So this is a driveway here. Right now it's asphalt. We're gonna rip all this out. We're gonna create the same footprint back where it is. And right now, if you see, the upper deck is actually tipped back towards the garage door, which obviously is a problem. So we're gonna fix that. We're gonna dig this side down quite a bit so we can get a little bit of pitch from the garage out towards the lawn. So this is gonna have to go down several inches from where it's at right now, especially this back corner. It's gonna have to go down quite a bit. So I'll get this ripped out and we'll get this set up today. You got anybody you wanna say hi to this morning?
I'll say hi to Rob and the grandkids and his wife.
Oh, you got somebody to say hi to this morning. All right.
I said that the other day.
No.
I said I just
you always say no. All right. Just take anything you want, man. It's not that serious.
No, you gotta go like this. You.
I would get out. All right, I'm gonna get started. I'm gonna start jackhammering this driveway out. We're taking that one piece of sidewalk out because the elevation's gonna change. And we'll probably end up taking that sidewalk section out as well, because that looks like it is pitched the wrong way completely.
You want to say something?
What's going on, everybody? Good morning.
Victor's there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Ready?
Do you really think you need a ski mask? No, I'm serious. It's like 50 degrees. Bob almost caused a 10 car pile up this morning.
What?
He's following me, right? So I come around the corner and he didn't make it. Traffic was coming. So I went up a little bit. I saw he didn't make it in my mirror, so I pull over. So he doesn't see me pull over on the side of the road somehow. So I honk as he goes by. He's in the left lane. He just cuts over two lanes of traffic to the right to pull over. Totally cut this car off. The car had to slam its brakes on, and there was a pickup right behind the car, and they're like, aah! And all these cars were right there. I was like, oh my goodness. He almost killed everybody. All right, driveway's all broken up into pieces. Breaking this up with the breaker took like 15 to 20 minutes. It's very, very fast, it's very easy. And then it breaks these pieces very small so you can fit more into the dump truck. You look like you're about to carjack Bob.
We'll be right back.
All right, Bob, go dump that. And don't be talking to them, girl.
I don't even have to stop at the scale over here.
Good. I know you don't have to stop at the scale, but I know you like to stop at the scale. Driveway's all broken up. One quad axle's full and out of here. I gotta walk all the way down the hill to my truck, disconnect the trailer, bring it up here. I should be able to fit the rest of the asphalt in my truck. And it'll just be a matter of digging down to get our proper elevation so we can get water to flow in the right direction. What you got? Chalupa? Tostada? Taco? A torta? Why don't you just call it a sandwich, man? It's just a sandwich.
That, do you like stuff like that?
It's all right.
I was going to make one today. I'll bring some tomorrow to get tried.
Oh, I'll eat it.
Yeah, it's going to be really good.
As long as it doesn't have like tongue and stuff.
Oh, no. No.
All right, we got the majority of that driveway in two very full dump trucks. Bob's truck was very full, and this truck is very full too. All we didn't get is the very end of the driveway here, and that ain't bad. That is not bad at all. It's going good. It's only 8:50. We're still waiting on Bugs. Bugs had to go do some touch up on the last job we were on, but he should be here soon. Bob's back already, so that's good. I'm gonna go park this. Bob can pull up and I can start loading because I gotta dig down, way down. Oh, Bobby. Bob makes me real nervous on these hills. All right, I'm gonna start digging down. We don't have any tools here. I don't have a level, string, nothing to check. Gonna have to go by eye for a little while until Bugs gets here with the truck. Come on, Bugs. See, what I'm doing here now is I'm digging down on this side so we can lower this edge of the driveway. When Bugs gets here, we'll run a string from the garage floor across and then we'll check it to make sure it's got at least an eighth inch per foot. I'm just kind of guessing now. I'm probably pretty close. I've been doing this for quite a while, but you can't tell. We don't have any tools at all with us right now. We're just kind of waiting on Bugs, who has a tool truck, and then we'll be able to really get our elevation established on this side. It's 9:35. We just took the first load of fill out, quad axle. I'm gonna fill this one. There's so much fill coming out of here.
Charlie, talk to your sandwich.
All right.
Heard Daryl's sick.
Yep. So I dug that all the way down, and this orange line finally has just a little bit of pitch coming away from the garage. So we got it. It's dug just about right here. Set this in here right now. Set this in here. Eric, set this board in here. I gotta take that last piece of sidewalk out and transition down.
Looks like we need to cut it.
Yeah, you wanna roll this in? It should be ready. All right, so I'm establishing some heights, and we scabbed these 2x4s together to make just a gentle radius all the way down this driveway. We'll pin it all in place. It's really the fastest way to do this. You gotta look down it, and you gotta make it look nice. You gotta move it in and out as needed. That's gotta go from there and curve around to the edge of this stone, the corner of the stone there, and set the height to the string. Did you cut that already?
Yes, sir, it's all ready. I'm gonna cut some rebar up. Yeah, it's all ready, Ryan.
So what I'm doing now is I'm shaving the edge of the grass down to kind of transition the lawn back down to the new height of the driveway, because the driveway, as you can see in the back, we actually took the driveway down about, I don't know, at least 6 inches. All right, it's 11 o'clock, almost 11 o'clock. Fueling up the skid steer. I always keep a transfer tank mounted on my excavation trailer. Hauling around 5 gallon jugs of diesel is really no fun. And actually emptying 5 gallon jugs of diesel into your skid loader is not fun either. So this has always worked really good for us. I'll go over the excavation trailer. A bunch of you guys have asked. Once we slow down, that'll be something that I can go over, is like the trucks and the trailer and how I organize things to be most efficient. A lot of you guys have been asking about that. If you set that like that, we're gonna have a problem stripping that form. Don't you think? You don't think so?
Cut it to fit.
Yeah.
Don't you think we'll have a problem getting this out?
Yeah, well, I'd cut it, yeah. You cut it to fit too, man. What you want, man?
Did you see all this from Charlie?
Charlie makes sure I got a bag full every day, man.
Thank you, Charlie. Just put some pins in there. That's great. Easy money for you today. You almost caused a big accident, man. You almost killed that person in the car.
I thought I put the blinker on and I didn't see nothing. I don't know what she's there.
And then there was a pickup right behind her that almost hit her or him, whoever was in the car. He almost killed two people, Bob, today. That would have been bad. All right, so we got the upper portion of the driveway all graded and compacted. I'm gonna rip out the little bit of asphalt here at the end, put it on this dump truck, the tandem, and then I'm gonna give Bob a load of fill, and then we'll finish up the forms and grade it, compact it. We'll be out of here. It's 11:45 right now. You can keep pinning this. It's not the height, but pin it. You can pin it all the way to here. All right, so we just keep working our way down the driveway. Got this side dug out, side's mostly formed up. Eric's setting the heights. I put a string up for the heights. And I'm just gonna go ahead and clean this side out here. I'll stockpile that gravel into the middle of the driveway so we can use that for grading. And we should be good to go. Pretty easy, easy money. The only thing difficult and time consuming about this job was how much we had to lower that upper portion of the driveway. Other than that, went pretty good. And then how slow Eric is, that always slows us down. And then he can't breathe when he's wearing that mask. He doesn't have enough oxygen to his brain. He can't even think straight. That's true, Eric. You know that. Alright, all we got left to do is to grade the end of the driveway. It's all set up and ready to go. I may need you tomorrow, because if it rains, we're going to go set another one. Okay. I got another big one in Germantown.
Is this all dirt or what?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's just dirt. Oh, I saw a picture on Facebook yesterday. A guy spilled, he had a bag of red powder, the dye,
yeah,
to mix in the concrete truck.
Yeah.
Spilled it all over the street. There was no gutter at all.
Especially red.
There was no gutter. It was in front of every driveway for like 2 blocks, and all the cars had driven,
He said he was cleaning it up for 3 days.
I bet red's the worst color.
3 days. Yeah. And he said he couldn't get it all up. He was asking for advice. Can you sweep a little faster, please? All right, I'm gonna go down the hill and hook up my truck to the trailer. And then I'll come back up and grab the Bobcat. All right, we're all done on this job. It's all, well, I shouldn't say we're done. We're done setting it up. So this driveway is gonna be about 30, I don't know, somewhere between 32 and 35 yards. But it went pretty good. It went about how I expected. And tomorrow morning, looks like rain again. Thursday morning, looks like rain again. We may not be able to pour this till Friday. So I'll either see you guys right here tomorrow morning for this concrete pour, or if there's just a chance of rain but it's not actually raining, I have another big driveway that we're gonna go dig out, concrete removal. So either way, I'll see you guys in the morning. Adios.